Welcome to the webcast, introducing and demonstrating the new NIAAA Alcohol Treatment Navigator. Speakers will be Dr. George Koob, Director of the National Institute on Alcohol Abuse and Alcoholism, and Dr. Lori Ducharme, Lead Developer of the Navigator. They will provide an overview and a walkthrough of the Navigator tool. Note that this webcast is being recorded. We will now start the presentation.
Hello, I am George Kubb, the Director of the National Institute on Alcohol Abuse and Alcoholism, and I would like to thank you for joining us today as we launch the new NIAAA Alcohol Treatment Navigator. As we have recently completed National Recovery Month, I am happy to introduce you to this exciting and important new online resource. Our webcast will answer several questions. What is NIAAA Alcohol Treatment Navigator? Why did NIAAA develop the Navigator? How is the Navigator different from other resources? And how can individuals, their families, and health professionals use the Navigator to find alcohol treatment? The Navigator is a tool designed to help people recognize and find quality care for alcohol use disorders. That is, care that is professionally led treatment grounded in decades of clinical and health services research. We developed the Navigator to address the alcohol treatment gap. In any given year, more than 15 million adults in the United States meet the diagnostic criterion for an alcohol use disorder, but less than 10% of them receive treatment. Meanwhile, many of those in treatment may not receive the care that best fits their needs. There are many reasons why people don't receive any alcohol treatment or the right treatment for their needs. For example, they don't know all the treatment options that are available, they don't know where to look, their doctors don't know where to refer them, or they don't know how to tell if a provider is offering good quality treatment, what we call, quote-unquote, evidence-based care. Often people call NIAAA looking for a recommendation or a referral because they don't know where else to turn. In fact, during my tenure as director of NIAAA, I've received numerous calls from colleagues and the general public asking for advice on finding good alcohol treatment providers in or near their communities for family and friends. Those calls inspired us to develop the Navigator, which makes this complicated process easier by telling people what they need to know and what they need to do to recognize and find quality care. Now, as a federal research agency, NIAAA cannot endorse or recommend any particular healthcare provider or program. Instead, we have created a resource that explains the steps to take in searching for an alcohol treatment provider anywhere in the U.S. That strategy is at the heart of the Navigator. Drawing on nearly 2 years of development with input from patients, their families, treatment providers, and leading alcohol researchers, the Navigator offers an easy-to-use and comprehensive resource that can inform the search for good quality treatment. It includes an overview of alcohol use disorder, a description of different kinds of treatment options, step-by-step instructions for searching several existing directories of treatment providers, 10 questions to ask and answers to listen for when interviewing a provider, 5 signs of quality to look for, and a downloadable toolkit to help organize and simplify the search process. With the Navigator, individual adults will be better able to find treatment options that meet their unique needs. Family members will feel empowered to help an adult loved one who may be struggling with alcohol use disorder, and primary care physicians and other health providers will have a tool to share with patients who may need a referral to alcohol treatment. We believe that the NIAAA Alcohol Treatment Navigator will be a game changer for people looking for quality treatment for alcohol use disorders. We hope you will visit the site and go through it and then share it widely. And we plan to refine and update the Navigator regularly, so please give us your feedback. It is available at alcoholtreatment.niaaa.nih.gov. Again, alcoholtreatment.niaaa.nih.gov. I will now ask Dr. Lori Ducharme, NIAAA's Program Director for Health Services Research and the lead developer of the Alcohol Treatment Navigator, to explain more about it and show you how it works.
Thank you, Dr. Koob. I'm Lori Ducharme, Program Director for Health Services Research at NIAAA. As a researcher who's been studying addiction treatment programs for more than 20 years, I can tell you from experience why the Alcohol Treatment Navigator is such a unique and important resource. Alcohol treatment can be very hard to find. Knowing where to look for treatment is difficult, mainly because the treatment system isn't really a system at all. It's an uncoordinated set of services that exist in independent settings and silos with different funding streams that, for the most part, are still not well integrated into general healthcare. That makes it really hard for people to find the kind of care that they need when they need it. The Navigator is designed to take the mystery and frustration out of the search process. Existing online resources are limited, and there really aren't any sites that bring all of the information together in one place to tell you what you need to know and what you need to do to find treatment. The Navigator does that. When searching online, it can be hard to identify good quality treatment when you see it. What are some signs of quality that you should look for? The Navigator helps with that. Another issue is that there are a lot of stereotypes about alcohol treatment. People often think their only choices are either a mutual help group or long-term residential rehab. And while those options certainly work for some people, they're not a good fit for everyone. In fact, a theme of the Navigator is that different people need different options. What worked for your friend or neighbor might not be the best fit for you, and that's okay. We need to help people understand the whole range of professional treatment options that are available and how to find one that meets your unique needs and preferences. For all of these reasons, searching for alcohol treatment can be confusing and overwhelming. We understand. In the process of developing the Navigator, we talked to many patients and families who had been through this process, and they shared with us their experience and frustrations, the mistakes they made, what they know now that they wish they had known sooner, and information they still have trouble finding. We're grateful that so many people were willing to share these experiences with us. We got input from patients and families at every step of developing the Navigator to make sure that our advice made sense, was easy to follow, and helped them feel more empowered to make these decisions about seeking treatment. And of course, we also involved researchers and treatment providers in the development of the Navigator to make sure it reflected the latest research and was grounded in the reality of today's healthcare system. One more thing, we chose the name Navigator deliberately. The Navigator is not a locator, although it will give you some tips on how to search specific provider directories. Rather, the Navigator offers a comprehensive strategy to help people search for evidence-based alcohol treatment that's delivered by skilled health professionals and help them choose among the many options that are out there to find one that best fits their situation. Through a combination of education, step-by-step instructions, resources, and tools, the Navigator is designed to help point the way to evidence-based alcohol treatment. Let me show you what it looks like. This is the homepage for the new NIAAA Alcohol Treatment Navigator. I'll start here to orient you to the site, and then we'll go through and highlight some of its contents. So the Navigator is all about helping you find your way for yourself or an adult loved one to alcohol treatment. The site is organized around two primary sections. One is informational, what you need to know about alcohol treatment. The other is the roadmap, a strategy for searching and finding treatment options. Let's start with the first section, what to know about alcohol treatment. So this section covers four topics. They provide some background and context to understand why your search for treatment and the options you need may be different than someone else's. In What is Alcohol Use Disorder?, we explain the signs and symptoms of alcohol use disorder, and we emphasize that it is a medical condition, often chronic in nature, that should be assessed and treated by a trained health professional. In What types of treatments are available?, we describe a variety of professional treatment options, including licensed professional therapists, outpatient and inpatient treatment programs, and physicians who specialize in addiction treatment. In the section, Why Do Different People Need Different Options?, we explain what goes into a clinical assessment and how a health professional will use that information to shape a treatment plan. That's what determines the type and intensity of treatment to consider. And then finally, we provide some information about treatment costs, how to find out about insurance coverage, and we emphasize that the most expensive option is not necessarily the best. Again, it depends on your specific needs. So let's just click briefly into the What is Alcohol Use Disorder page. Here you can see that these pages are all brief and easy to read, with links if you're interested in more detail. And there are navigation buttons both on the side and the bottom of the page so that it's very easy to move through the site. So that's the What to Know section of the site. Now let's go up here to the top navigation bar and we'll click over to the section on how to find alcohol treatment. Now, this section is really the heart of the Navigator. This is where we give you a strategy, some tools, and some step-by-step instructions for searching for treatment. We know this can be overwhelming, so we really want to take the stress out of this process by breaking it down into smaller steps. There are three parts to this. First, we'll give you some signs of quality to look for. Not all treatment programs are the same, and this will help you differentiate between them. Next, we'll show you how to find professional treatment providers and how to decide if they're a good fit for you. And finally, once you've come up with a short list of potential options, we'll give you a tool to help you choose among them. So first, let's look at what we call five signs of higher quality care. How can you tell whether a treatment provider offers good quality treatment? This is about helping people become better consumers of healthcare information. It's really important to look beyond the television ads and glossy brochures and websites that promise a cure. Those can be rather seductive messages when you are desperate to find help, but it's important to take a step back and really look at what a provider is offering. We looked at both the accumulation of years of health services research, as well as the current state of the treatment field and the consensus of experts. And from that, we selected five signs of quality that can be applied to the whole variety of treatment providers and span the continuum of services from initial assessment through treatment and long-term recovery. The five signs that we suggest people look for are, first, credentials, the specific licenses, certifications, education, and training that are associated with expertise in alcohol treatment. Second, you want a provider who will conduct a comprehensive assessment. That means they don't only focus on the person's alcohol and substance use issues, but the whole variety of medical, mental health, and other issues, including their housing situation, employment, and social support networks. Third, it's important that a provider involve the patient in developing a customized and responsive treatment plan. This reinforces the idea that there should not be a one-size-fits-all approach to treatment, and the treatment plan should be updated as the patient progresses through treatment and as their needs and goals change. Fourth, we talk about the importance of finding a provider that uses evidence-based therapies in treatment, including both behavioral therapies or counseling techniques, as well as considering the use of FDA-approved medications when appropriate. And finally, we recommend finding a provider who either offers or will help develop a plan for long-term continuing recovery support, reinforcing the idea that alcohol use disorder should not be addressed as an acute illness, but rather in a chronic or continuing care framework. Each of these expands to provide the kinds of details I've been describing. So, for example, here is what the credentials item looks like when it's expanded. For each type of provider, we give you the specific credentials, degrees, licenses, and letters to look for. Okay, so five signs of quality to look for, written in a way that's easy for people to understand. Now, certainly there are more than five indicators of quality, and these are not a guarantee of success, but they should help you assess your options. Now I'll show you the search section. Here, we orient you to three different types of professional treatment providers: licensed professional therapists, accredited treatment programs, and board-certified addiction doctors. At the bottom of this page, we link into a step-by-step search strategy for each of those three provider types. In each of those sections, we link out to an existing, publicly available national directory of professional treatment providers and show you how to search it. It's important to point out that there is no one central, curated list of treatment providers across the United States. This would all be much easier if there were. But that's exactly the reason why we built the Navigator, because it can be very difficult to understand and find all your options otherwise. Now, I'm not going to click through all of these pages, but I do want to show you how this is organized so you can see the general strategy involved. So let's first look at addiction therapists. Each of these three sections are organized in the same way. First, we tell you what you'll be searching. In this case, it's the Psychology Today directory. Then we briefly describe what these providers do. We alert you to any quality indicators that may be relevant as you're searching. And then we lead you through the search itself. A point we strongly emphasize is that you should not be making any treatment decisions based only on what you find in these directories. It's really important to call up a provider first and ask questions to learn more about them, about their approach to treating alcohol use disorder, and to see whether they would be a good fit for you. To help with that, we provide a list of 10 questions to ask a therapist before your first visit. You can preview those questions here. So let's click on question two here. And what you'll see is not just the question itself, but also an explanation for why we suggest you ask the question and what answers to listen for. And the idea is, as you interview a provider, two things will happen. It will start to shape your opinion about them and whether they might be a good fit for you, and their answers will tie back to those five signs of quality that we talked about earlier. So those are questions you'll want to be prepared to ask. Now, as for searching, we provide a link out to the Psychology Today directory, which is here. Again, this is not an NIAAA resource. You'll be searching their website directly. And then to help you make sense of your search results, we also have a downloadable set of search tips. These will show you click by click how to use that directory and how to narrow down your results. And then we provide similar advice for searching for specialty treatment programs. Again, same structure. What do these providers do? Signs of quality. 10 questions to ask and answers to listen for. And here we have a simplified search tool that will pull from the national inventory of specialty addiction treatment programs that is maintained by our sister agency, the U.S. Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration. And the third of the three sections. Here we talk about addiction doctors as an option. Again, what they do, signs of quality, questions to ask, tips for searching. And in this case, we link out to two existing directories, one that lists doctors who are board certified in addiction medicine, and the other for doctors who are board certified in addiction psychiatry. Okay, so the search section of the Navigator is very dense, but we've really tried to break it down into smaller, more manageable steps with lots of clear instructions. If you do all that searching, you'll hopefully end up with a short list of providers in your area, and you can narrow down that list by calling and asking questions about their treatment approach. But then how do you make a decision? So we also created a companion toolkit for the Navigator, and among other things, it includes a treatment options chart that you can download and save. It looks like this. Now, this may not be necessary for everyone, but this may help you organize your notes and compare apples to apples across the providers you've talked to. If you've called and interviewed these providers using the questions that we suggested, you should then be able to fill out this chart. These last five columns here on the right map onto those five signs of quality that we mentioned earlier. And from there, the idea would be that, all else being equal, people would prioritize those providers that have more indicators of quality, assuming that they are a good match for your specific needs and circumstances. I'll come back to the homepage to show you one more section of the Navigator, and that's this section on support through the process. When we did early focus groups with patients and their families, they encouraged us to include a section like this because these were things they really wish they had known. So we talk about how to start the conversation with a loved one who may need treatment. We talk about managing expectations around treatment, how long it may last and what to expect. Understanding relapse, that it's a common part of the recovery process and does not mean that the patient has failed or that treatment didn't work, and what should happen next. Long-term recovery support resources, again, reinforcing that addiction is not something we address as an acute episode, but a condition that will require long-term support. And finally, support for you. If you are using the Navigator to search for treatment on behalf of a loved one, how can you be helpful, and what kinds of help and support are available for you? So that was a very quick overview of NIAAA's Alcohol Treatment Navigator. I just want to restate how grateful we are to all of the families and providers and scientists who provided input into this website. We hope that it helps inform people about all of their options, that treatment is not one size fits all, that there are some signs of quality to look for and that can increase the chances of finding evidence-based care, and that the Navigator's tools can help people search for, interview, and make informed choices about treatment options that will meet their needs.